Hello everybody, welcome to Embrace the Red. Today we're going to talk about the anatomy of a compromise. Let's dive right into it. So if you look on how compromises happen and how organizations are breached, they all these like attacks, they follow a very kind of common pattern that I want to walk through right now with a couple of variations, and I'm going to provide a few examples of frameworks that talk about this as well. So if you look at that, in the very beginning, you have sort of the scary internet on the left, on the bottom, you see that, the scary internet, and you have some adversary that is roaming around the internet. And the adversary has objectives, right? They have certain goals they want to achieve. For instance, they might want to do data exfiltration, or they want to get controls of systems, right? Or do some ransomware attacks, very, very popular right now, right? To do extortion. They might want to do denial of service attacks or cryptocurrency mining and so on. And all that is between them and their objective is sort of your corporation or your company, your organization. And this is about cybersecurity, so we have computers in the organization, and this is now where the first step sort of starts for the adversary, right? They try to get an initial compromise, or what we call a beachhead. And there's a couple of steps involved in that, right? There's general reconnaissance, trying to figure out more about the corporation, what the corporation is like using, what's operating systems, what applications are running, what's the exposure on the internet, right? They might look for leaked credentials. There's lots of like stolen credentials out in the internet or in a black market to buy. You might have heard of collection number one or collection number one, like 2-7, I think, through seven. So there's lots of like possible avenues for an adversary to gain access to a corporation or establish that beachhead. There's also very targeted attacks when it comes to password spray or like phishing attacks. And so this is sort of this first stage, establishing the beachhead. And after the adversary has done that, they start propagating through the network of a corporation, right? They try to gain more insight, again, doing reconnaissance and gaining more insight in the corporation to perform lateral movement and navigate through the environment. And this sort of helps them learn more about the company, right? You might have SharePoints, websites, or other information on the intranet that then educates the adversary about other systems or other environments in your organization. For instance, there might be a production environment that they learn about reading documents that are exposed within the company, right? There might be certain compliance zones, or like for instance PCI, credit card numbers, they might be somewhere totally different, right, in a separate environment because of compliance reasons. The adversary might try to gather more information about those, as well as very popular now the last decade or so is also this, like there's more and more cloud environments that companies use, right? That's another thing that an adversary might try to find more information about. And this is sort of how systems usually work, is these things are separate zones or environments, and then there's these jump boxes. That's often how they're called in Windows environments, jump host or jump box. And then the adversary uses those jump boxes, which is the legitimate way an engineer would access these other environments, and they then navigate and pivot from the corporate environment or for their own laptop or their own computer into a production environment or these other compliance zones or directly into the cloud. So this is sort of this overall template on how a compromise happens in when an organization is breached. There's one final step also, is that this navigating or this pivoting through the corporate environment is often not really necessary, right? Now companies often do zero trust, or beyond core, how Google calls it. So this often means that an adversary can actually directly from the internet directly compromise, for instance, a cloud environment if the company does not have good access control in place. So the step to navigate through the corporate environment is not necessarily always required. Imagine, for instance, you have a user with the laptop in a coffee shop, right? And they have, let's say, SSH exposed on the MacBook. then anybody in the coffee shop can try to brute force that machine, gain access to that laptop. And then if that is sort of a zero trust laptop, there's no need now to even establish a VPN connection into the corporate environment. That laptop might already have all the certificates and identity provisioned that is necessary to move into the production environment or into a cloud environment. So to recap now, we talked about three stages. We talked about the initial compromise, we talked about this propagation phase, and we talked about the objective. And if you're familiar with the MITRE ATT&CK framework, or also with the unified kill chain, you can split all these tactics. For instance, in the MITRE ATT&CK framework, you can split them into these three buckets that I explained in the previous picture or animation. So you have all these various tactics, and you can fill them in to sort of simplify the view a little bit on where these tactics of the ATT&CK framework fit in. So, and the third way to look at this is basically this pivoting or lateral movement phase that I talked about. So the third way to kind of graphically think about this is there's actually, again, only these three stages, which is this overall reconnaissance phase. Then the attacker finds a vulnerability, exploits it, and then they look again for another like thing to exploit, and then do more reconnaissance, find another exploit, and sort of this loop keeps going until the adversary kind of reaches their objective. So this is another more simplified way of looking at how a compromise occurs. Yeah, so finally, let's look at this picture again just for completeness. So this is sort of this template pattern on how companies are compromised and where sort of these most significant steps of a breach are taking place. I hope this was interesting.